Good morning. This is JHS Weekly. I'm Mariah Vasquez.
And I'm Maxine Heng. Project Prom will be after prom on April 8th, but you need to go ahead and mark your calendars for the sign-up night, March 3rd. If you sign up that night, you will save $5 on your ticket. There will be some changes coming to Project Prom that will be announced soon, but remember your cost will be $15 for a night of fun, including the prize raffle, if you sign up on March 3rd at the high school in the health room at 6:30.
Juniors and seniors, Mercy Hospital is hosting a professional panel for Joplin High School students on Tuesday, February 21st from 6 to 8 p.m. at Mercy Hospital Joplin in the Conference Center. Whether you are planning to enroll in college or enter into the workforce, this will be a great place to learn about potential jobs opportunities associated with hospitals. Come and learn about all types of jobs associated with hospitals. Many professions will be represented, including non-clinical and clinical jobs. This is a free event, but RSVPs are requested. See your counselor for more information or to RSVP.
SkillsUSA recently hosted an event in Franklin Tech. Here's Emma Williams with more.
This week, SkillsUSA came together and had their district competition.
We're doing 6 or 7 different contests. Auto tech was today, HVAC, welding, engineering, including architectural and technical drafting, and then all 3 culinary competitions happened here today. After this, we go, obviously, to Southern for the leadership. Next Thursday, we're going to have a celebration. Everyone gets their awards for all the different contests that have happened over the course of this week. From there, then, first, second, third place get to move on to state competition, which happens in April. In order for a student to be involved in SkillsUSA, they have to be in a Franklin Tech class. And not just any Franklin Tech class, they have to be in the technical science classes or the health science classes. So it could be culinary arts all the way to welding, any of those classes. So they must be in those classes before they're eligible to be a member. The biggest thing, it really prepares students to be not only prepared to go to college, which is part of the thing that we do, but also prepares them to be ready to go to work. So eventually, everyone, we hope, is going to work. That's why we're in school, right? So they have the opportunity then to gain those three important skills: personal skills, one-on-one conversation, being able to communicate, technical skills, and then job place readiness skills.
The reason I'm in SkillsUSA is because one of the extra skills that you learn, which are important to workplace, like how to write a good resume, how to present yourself in a way that's approachable to employers, but also like just how to interact with people that you don't necessarily know, how to build these general conversational skills and how to get along with people in general. I've been staffing them since I'm district president, but it's a lot of work, and it's great to see that all the work that we're putting in as people working the competition, it's good to see that these people are actually enjoying themselves and they're not thinking of it as, oh, I have to compete. It's, hey, how do I show what I know the best? It's very diverse. I mean, there's speaking events, there's speaking events, technical spelling and math. So, I mean, you don't have to be necessarily good at the regular stuff you think in FDC to do this. I mean, there's a lot of potential, and seeing it go untapped is almost a shame.
From JetHD, I'm Emma Williams.
Thanks, Emma. Auditions for the spring musical Cinderella are quickly approaching. The auditions will take place after school in the auditorium. February 28th will be the singing auditions, March 1st, the dancing auditions, and March 2nd will be based on acting. You will need to attend all 3 nights of the auditions. You can pick up audition packets and the music from Ms. Trotnick's room in room A125.
All juniors, if you have not yet received your required vaccine for your senior year, the health department will have an open walk-in this Friday, February 17th. Since it's a no school day, take your immunization record with you. Please refer to the letter that you received with your first semester report card concerning this requirement, or talk with the school nurse if you have any further questions. The school nurse must have a copy of your school records to be updated with this vaccine.
Yearbook has some good news and bad news. The bad news is February 16th is the absolute last day for senior recognition ads for the yearbook. These appear in the back of the book after the senior section. The good news is anyone can order a book. However, time is running out. There won't be any extra books ordered this year. Those interested in ordering a book should see Ms. Crane in B116 to put down $20, with the amount to be settled before the 1st of May. Don't delay and be sure to order yours today.
Congratulations to the following 4 wrestlers qualifying for the state wrestling tournament this past weekend: junior Jacob Bartlett, senior Solomon Garcia, sophomore Jaden Withrow, and sophomore Jacob Boo. Good luck this weekend at the state tournament in Columbia.
The theater department is prepping for their upcoming musical and seeking aspiring actors. Here's Heaven Hudson with some more details on the upcoming auditions.
If you or anyone you know is interested in getting involved in the spring musical, tryouts will be held February 28th, March 1st, and March 2nd. For more information, visit Ms. Trotnick's room, A125.
Auditions are going to be in the auditorium after school on three separate nights, February 28th for singing auditions, March 1st for dance auditions, and March 2nd for acting auditions. For our spring musical, we'll be doing Rodgers and Hammerstein's Cinderella. Anyone can audition for the play. It doesn't matter if you're a freshman or a senior. Auditions are completely open.
I'm Heaven Hudson with JHD.
Wow, I really love Cinderella. We're going to have to check that out.
Yes, we do. Thanks, Heaven. Anyone wishing to audition for jazz band for the next school year, please sign the bulletin board outside of the band room. Music will be given to those that sign up. Auditions will occur in March. We are needing all jazz instruments, but especially alto, tenor, and baritone saxophones, as well as piano. If you have any questions, contact Mr. Wassner in room A126.
Next Thursday, the 23rd, from 4 to 6 p.m. in the cafeteria, Book Club will host a Black History Celebration. Sign up to read something from a Black author by emailing Ms. Adcock at sarahadcock@joplinschools.org or stop by her room, D319. Donations will be accepted but are not required. They will go to benefit the Joplin Emancipation Park Days.
Have you been looking for a new genre of music to jam out to? Here's a new JHD series Top 3 with KDG.
Welcome to Top 3 with KDG. This week, our genre of music is funk. These are our top 3 songs you should try and listen to and have a great time. I'm going to start off with Get Down Tonight by Casey and the Sunshine Band. This song really gets you in a groovy mood, and I'm telling you, man, it has funky roots. From start to finish, it's nothing but that great funky sound. Now to the real funky stuff. Play that funky music by Wild Cherry. I could rock out on guitar like Alan Wentz. He rocks out, but Rob's vocals, man, legendary. The last groovy song I have for you is Vehicle by the Ides of March.
Inside my car, I got pictures, got candy, I'm a lovable man, and I can take you to the nearest star. I'm your vehicle, baby. I'll take you anywhere you wanna go.
Who doesn't love the friendly stranger in the black sedan? Ah, this song is so groovy yet so relaxing. I love driving home with my windows down and grooving out. Well, that's all the time we have today. I hope you enjoyed these funky songs. I'm Katie with Top 3 with Katie G.
Wow, that was really awesome. I like this new series a lot.
Yeah, I'll have to check out some of that music. Thanks, Katie. If you are a sophomore and interested in representing Joplin High School at the Leadership Conference in the summer, see Ms. Burgess in the Guidance Office for more details.
Make sure you check your emails daily for upcoming information around the schools.
Starting in the year of 2019, students will be required to take a citizenship test. Here's Hallie Robinson with more.
The United States Citizenship Test will be implemented into all American history classes in 2019.
Citizenship test is going to be given to American history students starting next year. Jay Nixon, the governor that just left, passed a resolution last summer that said that all Missouri students entering the school year in 2017 as freshmen will be required to take it. So we are compiling our own personal test and we'll be giving that to American history students. The test will have 100 multiple choice questions on it, and they're gonna come from tests that people that actually have to take the citizenship test take, and then some various questions we ask throughout the year. This is being tested now because many people in the state were probably looking at test scores, thinking that it's extremely important that students just understand the basics of American history and government. So in addition to that EOC, they wanted to test them in other ways.
We asked some of your JHS students some of these questions on the test to see if they would have passed. Name one U.S. territory.
The Dominican Republic.
One American Indian tribe in the United States.
Cherokee Indians.
Name one of the longest rivers in the United States.
Mississippi River.
Name three of the 13 original states.
Pennsylvania, New York, and Michigan.
What is the ocean on the east coast of the United States?
Atlantic.
Who is the current Speaker of the House of Representatives?
Paul Ryan.
Who is the president during World War I?
Theodore Roosevelt.
What do we call the first 10 amendments of the Constitution?
The Bill of Rights.
Who is the Commander-in-Chief of the military?
The Commander-in-Chief is Mr. President Donald Trump.
You know, honestly, I'm not sure if I know half of those.
Yeah, me too. Good thing I'm graduating.
This has been JHS Weekly. Have a great week.